For decades, Muhammad Ali has run a small souvenir shop just steps from the Basilica of the Annunciation in Nazareth, selling religious trinkets and other items to the pilgrims who come to this town by the busload. Nazareth, where the church bells compete with the calls to prayer from the mosques, is a predominantly Arab city of Muslims and Christians within Israel. Taha Muhammad Ali came here as a boy after his family's home in a nearby village was destroyed in the 1948 war. With just a fourth grade education, he is a self-taught man, a voracious reader who quotes Steinbeck and Shakespeare, as well as classical Arabic poetry. He decided to be a writer as a boy and worked daily to make it happen.
I thought that if I want to express myself, I have to know what is poetry and what is good poetry. And this went together, reading and trying to write.
In one short poem translated as Where, he writes that poetry hides.
So poetry hides. How do you find it?
You have to take the pen and to take a paper and to be ready to wait for him. Otherwise he will come and you are not there. As a writer, you have to train yourself to write. Write anything, but every day.
You see,
Muhammad Ali's work has been translated and made available to an English-speaking audience by Peter Cole, an American poet and publisher who's lived in Jerusalem for 20 years. Cole's wife, Adina Hoffman, is now writing a biography of the poet.
I think there is two kinds of language. One for the news, for the politicians, and this is the broad, and one for poetry, and this is metaphors and descriptions. And they are different, very different languages.
Muhammad Ali insists that his poetry does speak to the conflict around him, but indirectly.
In my poetry, there is no Palestine, no Israel. But in my poetry, suffering, sadness, longing, fear, and this is together make the result Palestine and Israel. The art is to take from life something real, then to build it anew with your imagination.
He illustrated how this works with a short passage from his poem, Twigs.
وَهَكَذَا اسْتَغْرَقْتُ سِتِينَ سَنَةً كَامِلَةً.
And so it has taken me all of 60 years to understand that water is the finest drink and bread the most delicious food, and that art is worthless unless it plants a measure of splendor in people's hearts.